So I am an optimistic kind of guy. Lately, I've been reviewing a bunch of motherboards and I was okay. I was actually getting ready to give some love to this guy. But Asus just released its latest Strix motherboard. It's a lot of sssa. Sometimes my teeth go one way and my tongue decides to go the other. And you know, one thing I know is to never miss a Strix review. So today I present to you the ROG STRIX X299-E Gamer Edition from Asus. I'm almost ashamed of saying this one is different, but this one is different. Roll that intro. Usually talking, STRIX motherboards are all about gaming computers. I mean that it will focus on its looks and on its performances. On the other side of this, STRIX are also trying to sell themselves. So Asus is always trying to balance their act between bringing as many features as a gamer is looking for and keep it affordable. For example, this board goes around $345. And what is clear to me, Asus has spent a lot of time making this board as appealing as possible. They really spent a lot of energy on its aesthetic. And it for me, it works. It's probably the most beautiful board I've ever reviewed. But without any further ado, and before we go to the aesthetics of the board, let's take a closer look to what's in the box. So, unboxing. All right, so the first thing we're gonna see here is a little empty box underneath, unprotected by its static bag, the motherboard. Underneath, and most importantly, we have a door handle sign. Here is our drivers on a DVD, coupon and stickers. Yet another layer of carton to remove. First, our padded eye shield. I like the fact that one of the sides is darker. That should match the chassis, which will go with this motherboard. An RGB cable extension for some LED exports. That's a new one. That's an RGB extension for addressable cable, but more about this later. We have a thermal sensor cable, two pairs of SATA cable, an M.2 solid state drive vertical mount, a two-way SLI bridge, some zip ties, M.2 solid state drive screws and screw razors, a front panel bridge, and here, surprisingly, even more M.2 solid state drive screw and screw razor. And finally, a Wi-Fi antenna for our dual band Wi-Fi adapter. Alright, so let's take a closer look to the motherboard itself. The motherboard comes in an 80x form factor, that means 30.5 cm by 24.4. So best for more compact kind of builds like mid towers, casings and such. The next obvious thing on the motherboard is its new socket, the LGA2066. Now, I'd like to note that Intel just released its new Xeon W processors, and they also use LGA2066 socket. So one might think, hey, same socket, so they're compatible, so I could possibly put a Xeon CPU on this STRIX motherboard. No, the chipset is not compatible to Xeon processors. It only can run so far X CPUs. All right, so let's move to the RAM. We have a quad channel configuration on the motherboard, but and that is an annoying part of the X series processors. Not all the X series processors have the abilities to take full advantage of a quad channel configuration. So 4-core processors will only be able to activate a dual channel configuration and therefore up to 64GB of DDR4 RAM. And only the processors which have 6 cores and up can activate the full 4 channels on this motherboard, and therefore up to 128GB of DDR4 RAM. In both cases, you can overclock your RAM up to an impressive 4133MHz. Since we are in the memory, let's go to our M.2 solid state drives. This motherboard can support up to two M.2 solid state drives, one vertically and one horizontally. It is good to note that the X299 chipset is Opten ready, meaning that in both cases, your M.2 solid state drive can transfer data up to an incredible 32 gigabit per second. The only problem is that most likely your M.2 solid state drive will thermo throttle, and that is why Asus came up with this ingenious idea of putting a thermopad right on the other side of our chipset heat shield. Alright, let's move to our PCIe lanes. So we have 6 of them, but of course the ones who really interest us are the ones who can handle up to 16 lanes. Picture this, they can deliver individually 16 full 3rd generation bus speed. That is massive! That means that we can run up to a 3-way GPU configuration right here and run it, all of them at optimal speed. You'd lose nothing. Do you know what that means? Do you?
Do you? Do you?
That means you're gonna need a lot of money to outperform this thing. Let's note that it was a real good idea to add those metallic reinforcements on each side of those 3 intakes because, well, let's face it, our video cards are not getting any slimmer. All right, so let's move on to our onboard connectors. So nothing groundbreaking here. We have a USB 2 connector, a couple of 3.1 first generation connectors, and well, that one is a little bit better, and I like seeing this on a nice motherboard. A 3.1 second generation front panel USB connector. Give it a hoo for 10 gigabit per second transfer rate. All right, IO back panel stuff to see what's there. Okay, so now is the time to take a closer look to our IO back panel peripheral stuff. Exciting. All right, starting from the left, we have our BIOS refresh button, a couple of USB 2.0, Asus, really, 2.0, 4 USB 3.1 first generation, R-Type A and Type-C 3.1 second generation USB plugs. Oh, I almost forgot, our LAN network plug. Now, Asus makes them red because there is this LAN guard on it, and that means that it is surge protected. And that's one thing that I really like with the Strix series. It usually comes a little bit more rugged because they know that gamers are just fearless. We have our Wi-Fi adapter, and that's 8, well, let me get this right. I think it's 802.11ac, meaning that it can theoretically transfer data all the way up to a gigabit per second. And finally, we have our 5 Supreme FX audio channel and the SPDIF optical inlet. All right, SATA. Let's check out our SATA stuff. SATA-wise, we have 8 SATA 3.0 plugs, which can all transfer up to 6 gigabit per second individually. All right, so we've just reviewed all the general aspects of the motherboard, but here comes my favorite part of the review, the enthusiastic part. This is usually where manufacturers have a little bit more liberty to try some new items, some new features. Sometimes we do have some really cool surprises, and today is no exception. Earlier in the video, I talked about the aesthetics of the board, and there are 3 aspects I'd like to address. The very first one is the aluminum finish of both our VRM capacitors and our chipset heat shields. They have this very nice aluminum finish, this little polish which really gives that expensive look to the board. This robustness yet delicate attention to detail, and I really enjoy this. Secondly, the aura sync effect. And if you don't know what that is, in a nutshell, the aura sync effect is simply syncing the different RGB through your components and through your build to harmonize their different lighting effect and their glowing. And on this specific board, we have a couple of RGB eras which really look awesome. The first one is housed right inside our IO panel, an RGB screen which loops up to 16 million saturated colors. And it really looks amazing. Once you see it, it's really hard to go back. I kind of look at my different builds here and wish I had this. And then of course you have this infinity mirror ROG logo, which sits in the middle of the board. The ROG logo is encapsulated in this infinity room where a bunch of mirrors are giving a 3D effect. And it already looks great with the studio lighting. Take a look at it with the RGB lighting. You kind of want to lick it. And it doesn't end here. We have an extra 2 RGB Aura compliant connectors, which will allow us to export some RGB cables around the chassis. And here is some innovation. We have a 3rd RGB Aura compliant connector, but this one is special. It is for addressable RGB cables only. RGB addressable cable will allow you to control individual LEDs on that cable to be more precise in your lighting effect. And that's something which will be subject to a separated video. I actually have one right here, but I do need to put a CP on this and install the Aura SDK software and do a little bit of building around it. So stay tuned for that. Keeping in the enthusiastic part of the motherboard, its custom water cooling abilities. As you may already know, I'm a big fan of it. And on the ROG STRIX X299-E gaming board, we can connect up to 5 individual fans, a PWM water pump, and a PWM all-in-one water pump. And that's quite important because if you want to make an hybrid kind of build, which, you know, includes an all-in-one CPU cooler and maybe a custom water cooling system for your GPU, this is exactly what you're looking for. You want to be able to have a very precise understanding of what's going on in the different loops. As usual, this board aims at a certain bracket in the market, which are the gamers. Some of the enthusiasts, but mainly the gamers, the people who's gonna want to build not only a high performing build, but a very good looking one too. If this appeals to you, as it does to me, then this is for us. This is our motherboard and we have absolutely no excuse. This board is only $35 above the X299 entry level, such as the Prime X299A, which I reviewed just a couple of weeks ago. Actually, if you haven't seen it yet, kinda used to work. You got homework to do. All right.